Speakers like the First Lady seem to be a rarity, though. A new study says most commencement speakers lean to the left. Jason Mattera is with the Young Americans Foundation, the group that conducted a study, and he joins us live. Good morning to you, Jason.
Good morning, Steve. Thanks for having me on.
It's great to have you. For 15 years, you've been looking at this, and you look at U.S. News and World Report's top 100 American colleges. And out of that 100, how many commencement speakers are liberal and how many are conservative?
Well, nearly half of them are liberal or lean to the left, and you have, if you're lucky, you have around six conservatives who are headlining commencement addresses.
Six out of 100?
Yep, six out of 100. I mean, we see time, year after year, time and again, where colleges and universities will recycle the same tired old liberals. For instance, you had Al Gore at Carnegie Mellon University, and he used it to talk about politics, groused that he wasn't the president after the 2000 election, talked about how global warming is the greatest threat to our civilization. Not radical Islam, but global warming.
Right.
My hometown mayor, Michael Bloomberg, used his speech at the University of Pennsylvania to bash gun owners and champion embryonic stem cell research. God only knows what Bill Clinton's going to say when he addresses UCLA. Let's just hope he keeps his pants on.
Hey, 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 now stop that. But it shouldn't surprise us. I mean, a lot of campuses are notoriously left.
Well, sure, they are, but they should be introducing their students to a variety of ideas, including conservatives. And even in instances where conservatives did speak, such as the University of Georgia, you had Clarence Thomas. Now,
right.
For most normal people, the opportunity to hear a Supreme Court justice is just awesome, and you're going to relish that opportunity, but not for the self-righteous, smug, leftist professors at that school, which demanded the school rescind the invitation, and they brought up as their rationale the much-discredited Anita Hill allegations.
Oh, I know it. If folks want to read the report, go to yaf.org. Jason Mattera, always a pleasure. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Steve.